Hey, Steph here for Tri-State Live on tristateindie.com, and I'm here with the David Wax Museum. Sue's David, and actually David's brother, Ben, who you might not usually see on an interview, but we thought it'd be kind of cool today to have him sit in and talk about the old days.
Yeah.
So, glad you're with us.
Cool, thanks for having us.
You guys had a really amazing set.
Thank you.
The crowd loved it from what I saw, a lot of people dancing, which is what you would want to see. And before we really get into your music, I want to ask one thing. Where did you find the donkey skull?
Well, I play a donkey jawbone. It's a traditional Mexican instrument. And David actually saw people playing them in Mexico. And so when we got the band started, he asked if I would purchase a jawbone. So I did. And you can get them off the internet for about $40. So I have been teaching myself to play over the past couple years.
Well, you do a great job. You look like you've been doing it for a long time.
Oh, thanks.
Great. And so I also want to get into a little bit of you went to a college where it was part cattle ranch and studies at the same time. And then you spent some summers in Mexico. And so, obviously, you generated this great love for Mexico and the Americana, and that has definitely been a huge influence in your music as to what you're playing now. And since your brother is here, maybe you guys can kind of talk about how it was before you had that amazing influence.
Yeah, so we grew up, my older brother played jazz guitar, and so we grew up with a lot of music in the house because my parents had tried to get him to play piano, but he didn't want to, so I started taking lessons. But our parents were very supportive about music, and there was a lot of great music going on. And also where Sue's grew up around, outside of Charlottesville, Virginia, there was a great old-time music community. But around us, there was jazz music, there was bluegrass, there were folk bands, alt-country. So that's the kind of stuff I grew up listening to and was influenced by a lot of alt-country bands that used to come through town in central Missouri where we grew up.
And you guys are really adamant about your email list. and making a connection with fans, like, that's great. I mean, I think there's a lot of independent artists out there that, you know, they might play a show, but they don't realize, like, you're doing it as you're playing, and you've got this great team of people collecting email addresses to really try and connect with your fans. Maybe you guys can talk about, like, why that's so important to you.
Well, we've been doing it since the beginning in terms of trying to get people on the mailing list, but it took on a particular importance to us when we were in a contest last summer to play in the Newport Folk Festival, and it was an internet vote-off contest. And so the reason that we were able to get into the Newport Folk Festival was because we had so many people on the mailing list and so many fans and supporters that kind of were really hitting the ground for us to try to drum up support and votes for this contest. And getting into the Newport Folk Festival was a real turning point in our career. And so I think we learned a lesson really early on that you need to know who your fans are, you need to be in touch with them, and you need to be able to let them know what's going on so they can help you and support you, because in this independent music landscape, that's all you've got, you know? Mm-hmm. You don't have anything else, you've got your fans. And so I think very quickly we realized, you know, we need to be, NPR gave us a little, jab about it, because they said we were cheerfully aggressive about our style in terms of getting people on the mailing list, but it's just those names are like gold to us, because then we know who our fans are and we can come back to the Philadelphia area and get the people back out again and get people to help spread the word about the shows. So we get a bunch of friends organized. This time we just wrote our mailing list and got people who are already on a mailing list, got into the festival for free in exchange for kind of helping us out with going around during our set to get names on the mailing list. So
that's great. It's really great.
Hey, that guy's got a David Wax Museum hat. Check it out.
That's the guy with the monkey from on stage. You're my favorite monkey. Except there's a real monkey. Come on, come say hi. Watch that wire.
Yeah, just don't trip over that.
This guy won a free hat at our... Wait, speak into the microphone, please.
Yes, your set was gorgeous. I loved it, except for...
I'll turn around so you can...
Oh! Oh, we're on TV! Oh, my God! Yes. Well, since you have a jawbone, we think you should change the name of your group to Samson.
Great idea.
You think you could do that? And we loved all the audience interaction. Who's that crazy guy with the camera? Oh my God. Okay, so we're running out of things to say.
That's great. Thanks so much.
We love that.
Only on Tri-State Indie.
See, connecting with fans. It's awesome. So, being that you played a lot of festivals, or I'm sorry, living rooms, and now you're playing festivals, what is that transition like for you, and what other festivals can we see you at this summer?
Well, we're doing a bunch of Canadian festivals this summer. We're going to be at Winnipeg and Calgary and Vancouver. But here in the States, we're going to be at the Dave Matthews Band Caravan in Governor's Island. In the Philadelphia area, we're going to be back at the Philadelphia Folk Festival. We could just announce that right now. And we're going to be at the Newport Folk Festival as well.
And this time we didn't have to win a contest to play at Newport. They invited us to play on their main stage. So we're very excited about
that. That's an amazing feeling, right?
Definitely.
Great. Thanks so much for taking the time out of your day to come and hang with us. And I hope you're going to at least see some of the rest of this festival.
Yeah, we're really excited about Josh Ritter and Anita Franco and Gogo Bordello and our friend Nicole Atkins, who just played.
Yeah, you guys played a couple songs with her, or
just
a song.
In, yeah, just sat in.
I unfortunately missed that.
Oh, that's okay.
I didn't realize that, and then someone told me, and I got there too late.
No,
so
don't worry.
Maybe another time.
Yeah, another time. For sure.
We'll do it again.
This is Steph with Tri-State Live with David Wax Museum. So thanks, guys.
Thank
Enjoy
you
the
so
rest
much.
Of your day.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thanks, Ben, for sitting in. It was great.